And after Jibreel came to our Prophet Muhammad in the cave, the Prophet, peace be upon him, returned frightened to Khadija's house. And he said, "Cover me, cover me." So she covered him until the state of fear was over. Khadija said, "What's the matter?" He told her what had happened and said, "I was afraid that something bad might happen to me." Khadija said, "Rather, I swear, Allah will never disgrace you. You keep good relations with your kith and kin, speak the truth, help the poor, entertain your guests generously, and assist those who are stricken with calamities."
Ya ayyuha al-muzammil, qum al-layla illa qaleela, nisfahu aw inqus minhu qaleela, أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. إنا سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا. إن ناشئة الليل هي أشد وطئا وأقوم قيلا. إن لك في النهار سبحا طويلا. واذكر اسم ربك وتبتل إليه تبتيلا.
Then Khadija went to Waraqa and told him about what happened to the Prophet, peace be upon him. Waraqa exclaimed,
"Holy, holy, by the one in whose hand my soul is. If that is true, then it must be the angel Gabriel, who was sent to Moses. And Muhammad is the prophet of the people. Tell him to keep firm."
Khadija went back to the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and told him what Waraqa was saying. And successively, the verses of the Quran were revealed to the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him. While the Prophet was walking, he heard a voice and raised his sight towards the sky. He saw Jibreel, the angel who came to him at the cave of Hira, sitting on a chair between heaven and earth. The Prophet, peace be upon him, fell on the ground from the horror of what he saw. And when his fear was over, Prophet went to his family and said, "Cover me, cover me." So she covered him. Then Allah Almighty revealed his saying, "O you who covers himself with a garment, arise and warn, revere your Lord, purify your garments, and abandon the abominations. Allah Almighty is truthful."
Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, qum fa'anthir, وربك فكبر وثيابك فطهر والرجز فاهجر ولا تمنن تستكثر ولربك فاصبر.
The Prophet, peace be upon him, began his call secretly. And Khadija bint Khuwaylid, may Allah be pleased with her, was the first one to believe in Allah. She believed what the Prophet, peace be upon him, said. So Allah relieved the Prophet's worries by her. Whenever his people contradicted him, she supported him, believed him, and brought him out of his sorrows. The Prophet, peace be upon him, began his call secretly for 3 years. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him, was the first man to believe in Allah.
I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah.
Thus Asma and all the family of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq believed in Allah. And the Prophet began explaining his call for the monotheism and to abandon idolatry to Abu Talib, and that the revelation comes to him from heaven.
O Muhammad, I cannot leave the religion of my forefathers and ancestors, so that the Arabs do not blame me. O my nephew, I am with you and I will protect you from your people if they contradict you, support you, and help you.
The Prophet's call began to spread among the people of Mecca. Bilal bin Rabah, may Allah be pleased with him, the Muazzin of the Messenger, embraced Islam. Ali bin Abu Talib was the first boy to embrace Islam.
I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah.
إنما وليكم الله ورسوله والذين آمنوا الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم راكعون. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَإِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ.
Also, Mus'ab ibn Umair, may Allah be pleased with him, embrace Islam. The men of Quraysh were watching what was happening with the Prophet of Allah. So they went to Umayyah.
My Lord Umayyah!
What do you want?
I saw Bilal sitting with Muhammad.
If this is true, I will torture him severely. Where have you been, O slave?
My lord, I was around here.
I heard you were sitting with Muhammad.
Yes, my lord.
What?
I believed in Allah and his prophet.
What are you saying? If you do not forget about this, I will give you a painful punishment.
I will not do, my lord.
So they tortured him and put him under the burning sun.
The one!
They put a heavy rock on his body.
The one!
Leave Muhammad, and we will set you free and clothe you in silk and gold.
The one!
You will suffer painful torment. Return to your gods.
The one!
We will not have mercy on you until you forget about Islam, black-faced.
The one!
Then Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, converted to Islam and bought Bilal to set him free and began calling his companions. Abdurrahman ibn Auf, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, and Talha ibn Ubaydullah. And those were the first eight people who embraced Islam. So they prayed and gave alms. Another group of senior companions, males and females, may Allah be pleased with them all, also embraced Islam. And after the number of those who converted to Islam began to increase, the fears of the people of Mecca began to increase, and they decided to get together to solve this issue.
What are we going to do with Muhammad and his companions?
Let's make Abu Talib a proposal. He will either hand Muhammad over us or fight us until one of the two parties win.
Send a messenger to Abu Talib for consulting. We will not let our gods down. Yes.
وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُ مَا أَلْفَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَاءَنَا أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ ومثل الذين كفروا كمثل الذي ينعق بما لا يسمع إلا دعاء ونداء صم بكم عمي فهم لا يعقلون.
When Quraysh knew that Abu Talib would not forsake the Prophet, peace be upon him, they came up with a strange and unprecedented idea.
What are we going to do with Abu Talib and Muhammad?
If we kill them, we will start the fires of war.
And if we remain silent, we will be lost, and our prestige will also be lost. What do you think, Abu Sufyan? Muhammad came with a religion that equals between masters and slaves, the black and white.
And he prohibits the infanticide of girls and the killing of the soul out of poverty.
I have an idea, and I hope that Abu Talib will accept it. What is it, O Ibn al-Mughira? Come with me.
O Abu Talib, we brought you Umara ibn al-Walid.
The best boy in Quraysh tribe and the most handsome one of them. So take him as your own son and hand over Muhammad to us.
Give us whoever runs counter to your religion and the religion of your forefathers.
He separated the father from his son. Are you giving me your son to look after him for you? And give us Muhammad in return? I give you my son to kill him?
Rather a man for a man.
I swear it's an unfair bargain. We are fair in that bargain, Abu Talib. I swear it's not fair, so do whatever you please.
And so Abu Talib refused Quraysh's offer.